So welcome to the 2018 Chapter of Excellence Showcase. My name is Rachel Dahlberg, and I'm one of the two Materla Excellence Initiative coordinators at SUNY Plattsburgh. I would like to introduce our reviewers today. This is Christina Vega, Assistant Director of Training and Summer Life at the University of Vermont. Then Benicus B. Vargas, the coordinator of Training and Summer Life at the University of Vermont. And Brandon Sarah, graduate advisor at the University of Vermont for Training and Summer Life. And then William Cantalosi, he's now our reviewer, but he's sitting in today. He's our graduate assistant at SUNY Plattsburgh. And Allison Swift-Dunn, director of Training and Summer Life at SUNY Plattsburgh, also not our reviewer today. Just here from the support. Okay? I would like to introduce Sydney Delta Town.
Thank you. Good morning, and thank you so much for giving us this opportunity to showcase to you our organization. We are the Gamma Upsilon chapter of Sigma Delta at SUNY Plattsburgh. I'm Ashley Dix. I'm the current president, and the positions I've held in the past are recruitment chair, community service chair, and assistant human rights coordinator.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Kelly Deeds. Thank you all for being here this morning. I currently hold the position of philanthropy, and in the past, I have been both recruitment chair and served DRMA board as the recruitment.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Nikki Umar. I'm the current vice president of scholarship for my organization, and in the past, I've held positions that include risk management, sports coordinator, and sunshine.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Ariel Tamayo. I am the current vice president, and I have held positions in the past of ISA delegate, sports coordinator, and new member educator.
Hello, everyone. My name is Grace Hogan. I joined Sigma Delta Tau fall of 2017. Although I'm a new member, I currently hold three positions. I am community service chair, alumni chair, and philanthropy chair.
So, as stated in our mission statement, Sigma Delta Tau empowers each member to reach their fullest potential, and I can proudly say that that's exactly what we do. Even standing here right now, we are filled with so much gratitude because we've never been able to do this, and we have seen so much improvement as individuals and also like as a sorority together. Chapter of Excellence would be such an honor. It's literally something that we talk about at every chapter meeting and every executive board meeting. It literally gives us like the fuel and motivation to get up every morning, get out of our beds, and be the our best possible selves. So one thing that I'm proud to say about Sigma Delta Tau is that we excel in leadership roles. When I was, I joined fall of 16, and in my new member education class, I just remember my new member educator being like, these 4 years are what you make of it, and you can either be the type of sister who sits around, gets her requirements done, but doesn't really make a difference, or you can be the sister who empowers one another, goes above and beyond. And I knew in that moment, I sat there and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna be president. And I knew that was a lot to think in that moment, but I think that the reason why I am president right now and representing this amazing organization is because of the fact that this organization is filled with so many leaders and really empower each other. And at all of our chapter meetings, we recognize all of our strengths, and every chapter meeting is filled with like snaps, which I think the reason why I'm also here is because I was always recognized for all my achievements. So every semester we have two sisters take part in the Future Materla Leaders program here, and I took part in that also. We value this so much because our new members leave a different person with more confidence. And then in spring 17, I, myself, and our Vice President Ariane Tamayo received the Future Emerging Leaders Award from SUNY Plattsburgh. When I was a new member, I realized that the one thing that we slacked at, that now we've improved at, is our attendance at conventions. And this summer, I attended our convention with our last Vice President, Julissa Vera, in New York City. We celebrated our 100 years as a national organization, which was very exciting. And also there, we were doing a service project and we cleaned up all the parks in New York City. And then this semester, our executive board took a trip to Ithaca for our national leadership development program. And we were able to talk to other executive boards from other chapters, learn their strengths and their difficulties, and basically just work off each other. And the one thing we took back that we really stick with is like, the way you portray your feelings towards your organization and chapter is the way that your members are gonna come back at you. So even if you're under pressure, you're stressed out, like you're just really upset right now, always portray your happiness and excitement, and that's something that we really value. And then we also have a lot of sisters in our organization portraying leadership roles outside of just our organization. Nicole is currently has three positions in ISA. She is the secretary and the treasurer, and she just recently became the head of the service committee. And then Jalissa Vera, last academic year, was the VP ISA standards. And something that we really are proud of is that we have two sisters sit on every committee. So we have two sisters on Easing Prevention, Diversity, Interfraternal Relations, and the Service Committee. And then we also have a lot of sisters involved on Shine On. I don't know if you guys know what that is, but it's a program that takes like a year to create. And we have two sisters, Madison Winters and Kenzie Caluso, on the committee. And then we have mentors such as myself, Cassidy Corson, and Brianna Currier. And this program has little girls around the northern country come from their fifth grade, and we teach them about self-respect, how to stand up for yourself, diversity, communication skills, and all that. And it's really empowering, and I'm very proud of that. And then another thing that we've progressed in is our educational events. We have huge philanthropy events, but something that we realized is that we don't have educational events. So last week we had we co-hosted an event with our brother fraternity, Zeta Beta Tau, and we had two national representatives come, and it was called Safe Smart Dating, and we spent 3 hours of our time talking about sexual assault, abuse, relationship do's and don'ts, what to do if like one of your members was sexually assaulted, and we talked about the things that happen on other campuses, and this was very moving, and it was very successful, and we're working with those people who came and seeing if we can do it again next semester, but have it open for the entire campus, because it is something that happens on campus and needs to be talked about. And then we also have sisters involved in other clubs on campus. So we have sisters in the Women in Leadership Club, sisters in the Fitness Center Advisory, and our secretary, Elle Mullen. She is going to be the president of the Cardinal PR next year. And then our sister, Katrin, was just elected as, not elected, she just won the job of being the special projects coordinator for the fraternity and sorority life. Other than that, Sigma Alpha Tau really does excel in leadership, and another thing that they excel in is scholarship.
Hi, so as I introduced myself before, my name is Nicole Iwan, and I am the current vice president of scholarship in our organization. So scholarship has always been something that has been seriously very important to me. So I always knew I wanted a position that really like influenced the importance of scholarship among my members. Just because I know my sisters and I know each of them has a brilliant mind and just below very much so cares about academics. So for our new member semester GPA, in the spring it was a 3.12, and in the fall it was a 3.14, so that's like a 0.02 increase, but we really worked hard to get it that way. And then our new member cumulative GPA is a 3.23, and I think that has largely part to do with the fact that our new members, when they're in the joining process, part of my job is to pair them up with older sisters in their major or that are taking similar courses to them so that maybe they can get some feedback and how their courses went for them, like some help if they're struggling in areas like that. And then when I took on this program, I noticed that I really liked a lot of the aspects of the program, and then I noticed that a lot of the program wasn't really working for our members. So I kind of, so before I took it on, we had mandatory study hours that we had to go to. They were twice a week for 2 hours. You had to go once a month. And they were only in the library, so you only had to go to the library to study, and so that didn't take into account the fact that like maybe you study like in the learning center, maybe you study at your home, maybe you study in your suite. So that's something that I genuinely felt that wasn't maybe working for some people, especially the people that maybe do struggle in school. So I changed that. Another thing we did was you pass a skippy jar around a chapter and you write your name in it if you didn't skip a class. Obviously people, could lie about it if you, I just didn't think that was really working, so I didn't like that, so I changed that. And then some of the new programs that I've implemented are, instead of hosting mandatory study hours, What I did was I now have mandatory scholarship-worthy points. So you can get, and those are once a month that each member can complete. Among this includes not just study hours at the library, but that is an option. You can visit the Learning Center, but you have to send me a copy of your appointment. You can visit the Career Development Center. You can tutor a younger sister or meet with an older sister in the same major or who is taking the same class as you. You can meet with a TA or professor during office hours, and all of those fall among scholarship-worthy points. And I think it's a better way to go about academic success, because I think in that way you're building relationships with your TAs, with your sisters, with your professors, and I think that that's more of like, because I didn't like the fact that we tried to quantify academic success in numbers during the week. I didn't really like that, so I changed that. And then one of the other new programs that I have, working with our local advisor, Jess Furtis, and this is going to be implemented next semester, but once a semester it will be mandatory for sisters to meet with each of their professors wearing their letters once a semester outside of class to build relationships with them, because I think that building relationships with your professors is so crucial, especially in a medium-sized college campus like this. I really think that a lot of our sisters are very outgoing and very enthusiastic about academics, and I want professors to know that Sigma Delta Tau really values scholarship and academic success.
Thank you. So we'll be moving on to questions now. So we have 10 minutes for questions.
So it looks like or sounds like there are some pieces that you didn't get to cover.
Yes.
Wow.
We're gonna have so much to tell you.
Okay, great. So we're gonna maybe try to frame our questions to get at some of that. So can you talk a little bit about your new member education? Can you talk a little bit more about what that looks like?
Yeah, sure. So because I was a new member educator, I can talk very highly of this. We work very hard to instill our values to our new members, and we provide them with programs and opportunities to kind of get the opportunity to like touch on every single one of our values. And just to throw like a few things out there, we do a new member retreat where you kind of share personal experiences, and you also share empathy between your new member class. We also do a Rosebud program, which basically is having a new member meet with an active sister once a week, just to exchange experiences almost and just create new friendships. And then as Nicole mentioned, we do the study buddy program between new members and active sisters, which help a lot with not only your academics, but it also helps create more connections.
Okay, so I'm gonna keep going. Can you talk a little bit about your financial management in terms of your organization, how that shows up for you all?
So for financial management, currently our treasurer is Nikki Castagna, and what she does is she'll budget out everything for us in the beginning of the semester to make sure that we're all in a good financial standing, not only with, as an organization, but so that we have the funds to be able to get everything we need. Because as we've talked about, events, I actually touched upon it for philanthropy, but events for recruitment and philanthropy are such a large part of what we do, and we want to make sure that these events are supported and taken into account and also done to the best of our ability. We really strive to make sure that, like, when it even comes down to the decoration, that it's done to the T. So funding and making sure that we have that in the right allotment is important, and she does a great job of letting out a memo for us in the beginning of the semester so we're all aware of exactly how much money we have to budget ourselves. And then in addition to that, we can also table and create more opportunities for financial leeway. But also, she does a really good job of making sure that we all have our dues paid before banquet, which is an incentive to make sure that financially we're all taken care of for the semester.
She also had our first chapter, it's called Retreat, and she hosts our entire budget, and we have to vote on it if we believe that it's fair.
Also, just to add to that, we do have payment plans for sisters that might be struggling, and she's very understanding of that. And then I do also take initiative to bring up, like, one of our sisters just got a scholarship through Sigma Delta Tau. So, like, sisters are always applying for scholarships that could help them pay for their dues.
Can you talk a little bit about how you hold each other accountable in your organization?
Usually we don't really like to use that, but we do use it when it comes to time. But at every chapter, I'm very like strongly worded, and I say like, you join this organization, like these are the rules, and like this is what needs to be followed. And like, it comes to a point where like, if you don't want to follow it, then you can like you can leave. And we don't really have a lot of problems. Like, we are very respectful of each other. And chapter is a time where if you do have a problem, you can speak it. We portray that a lot, that if you do have something that you don't feel is right, you're allowed to talk about it, and that's the time where you can talk about it so that we don't have problems of this sister talking behind this person's back or this person doing this. But we don't let things like brush under the rug, and if it does come to something big, like we don't want to take things away, but like we can, or we can add like community service hours.
Can you talk a little bit about maybe navigating some of the requirements of office, how you are able to manage going to the events and that kind of stuff?
So one thing Mariana did, I'll let you take it, which is just started off, she's amazing, and she set up a program for teams within our organization. It also ties into holding members accountable to be going to events, but yeah.
So as vice president, I noticed there, and also I was a previous ISA delegate, so I was kind of getting a feeling that we were supporting other NPC organizations more than we were supporting our cultural-based and multicultural-based organizations here. So what I did was created a team, essentially, and we have three teams, the Sigma team, the Delta team, and the Tau team, and they're divided based on your availability after 6 p.m., because usually events are later on in the evening. And I divided up into having mandatory events for each team based on your availability, and you get a point, well, 5 points for going to events, and at the end of the semester, the person with the most points gets a reward. So just to create kind of incentives to go to these events, and points are used for multiple things, scholarship and a ton of things, but you do get rewarded for doing all these types of things.
Also, just to add to that, one of the great things about having sisters go to these community meetings is that they bring back to chapter so much more enthusiasm, so that it really drives other sisters to want to go to these events with them, especially hosted by like culture-based and multicultural organizations.
So now that that's more of a requirement, are you seeing that there's a sharper relationship?
Oh yeah, definitely. Okay. Definitely, yeah. Without a doubt, it's changed so much within our organization in at least the past year. There's been a large increase in our involvement with multicultural organizations and our relationships with them and friendships with them. Yeah.
Of course, have you?
3 minutes, 30 seconds.
Great. So I guess the best way to kind of wrap this up, I think, in my head, if you maybe each of you want to say like one or two things wants to know as we wrap this up, just given that we have like 3 minutes left.
You want to start since you can.
I talked about community service, so I'm the community service chair. We require 15-hour community service per semester. I like to break it up in a way where each month 5 hours is required. They don't have to do it that way, but I figured it's just easier that way instead of doing 10 and then 5, struggling, rambling. But we always have opportunities for community service out of being in constant contact with Project Help. Which is an office here that gives us opportunities almost daily. Also, in the fall, every semester we have a thing we do together in the fall. That's Miller, who's sitting right there, organized to go to the Ronald McDonald House in Burlington, Vermont, and bake cookies for families with children who have cancer. And this semester we do Day of Caring, which is in the local Plattsburgh area. We rake leaves for the surrounding neighborhoods. And it's 100% attendance rate there, and everybody wants to be there. We're all there as an organization. We're all having a good time while giving back to the community. So each semester there is at least one thing that we do together, and there's also smaller things that everyone does.
I can touch on our philanthropies for a bit, if that's all right. So we support Parent Child Abuse America and Jewish Women International. We have annual events that occur both every year in the fall and in the spring. So our event for the fall is Powder Puff. It's a bracketed flag football tournament where we ask our sororities as well as other organizations, because again, we're really big into getting the community involved, and we want to showcase that not only we care about these organizations and we care about our philanthropies, but what's so important to us is that it becomes important to the community. We want them to understand the values of each philanthropy, understand what we're working towards, and not only just throw us a dollar, but truly care about prevent child abuse and about empowering women. So we worked with Chi-Phi every year to help better our fraternal relations with them, and we set up a bracket, and every sorority and also like cheerleading, Kickline, and other organizations participate. And last fall, we were able to raise over $1,500 towards our philanthropy, which is a really large accomplishment for us. So we were really happy about that. And then in the spring, we do Sig Delta Sweetheart, which is the event that I coordinated this year. Again, asking for volunteers from each fraternity as well as sports teams so that they can come and support us. They participate in like congeniality and competition where they do talents and they have to compete and then we crown a winner. Allison was one of our judges for this year, so I hope she enjoyed that event. And this semester so far, we were able to raise over $700. So we've really improved in what we've taken into consideration when it comes to philanthropies, but outside of just our main events, we also strive to not sink back into this regression of being okay with just comfortability and routine, because we do have these annual philanthropies. We're constantly trying to progress ourselves, saying what can we do better, how can we improve this, what can we add to our programs. So last fall we added a full parents weekend where all of our parents were invited up to campus, and we also had a benefit banquet which we made proceeds go towards Prevent Child Abuse America, where we had a Dana Trustee anchor, and it was such a great fulfilling time to spend with your parents and like truly have a heart to heart about the fact that you care about these philanthropies and your family is supporting you. They came all the way out here to see us, and it was really a great event. Also underway is hopefully one of our sisters is really fluent in Taekwondo, and she wants to set up a workshop with our sisters to teach us Taekwondo, and then we're trying to, in future semesters, open it up and have it for empowerment for the campus itself.
Thank you.